Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the movie The Gentlemen. This is Guy Ritchie's 11th feature, and lately he's been doing films like Sherlock Holmes, Aladdin, King Arthur, big blockbusters. Well, he returns to his gangster roots with this film, The Gentlemen. We're here at an authentic British pub. It's called The George and Dragon. If you're ever in the Phoenix, Arizona area, you have to come and visit it. But we thought, perfect place to tease our big cast interviews. Take a look.
Retirement doesn't sound so bad. Long walks in the countryside, pruning roses with my better half, raising some cubs. I've earned it.
This is really about a guy who just wants to retire, wants to hang out with his wife. He's just trying to. Have you actually thought, each of you, what you might do? Should you ever retire?
Look, I don't know about you all, but I'm in a fortunate position to where, like, the idea, you know, some people have jobs, some people have a career. It's nice to have a career. The idea of retiring and playing golf all day, and I know you've got some of the greatest courses in the world, Scottsdale. But to doing that every single day, I think I would go crazy after about 18 months. Yeah. I really have no interest in retiring.
Good. We're glad. How about you? Have you thought about it?
Me too, actually. Yeah. I think I just want to be doing this until, you know, I can't remember my lines anymore.
The industry itself, and the craft is, you evolve as you grow older.
And
the roles that maybe you took as you were younger aren't exactly going to be the same as you're going to take later in life.
Yeah.
So it's forever keeping you on your toes, and that's what I'm excited about. Mm. Just keep on going.
I think it's a good question for everyone to ask themselves.
Yeah.
What would I do if I no longer did this by choice, or if no one was hiring anymore? What would I do? You know, it's a good question.
I want you to imagine a character. Your boss, Mickey Pearson.
You're too smart to be blackmailing us, Fletcher.
I am not a patient person, so when Hugh starts setting the scene and telling the story, I thought, oh God, this is going to be a long story. And then I reminded myself, this is Guy Ritchie telling the story. He can take as long as he wants. What's another film of yours where, you know what, Guy Ritchie's touch would have jazzed this thing up?
Ooh. Would have jazzed it up.
You'd love to have seen his version of it.
Carry on. Maybe we get this end. What do we have? Okay. 5 minutes.
We have 5 minutes.
Come back.
Yeah, we'll
come back to that. Who's this guy, by the way, behind the bar?
Oh, your friendly barkeep.
I feel like we should acknowledge you because you're going to be in a bunch of interviews around the country.
And if you smell smoke, it's because there's a fire.
That was such a cool marriage.
Yeah, I think it's a pretty cool relationship that they've got.
Yeah,
and I think also Rosalind is not. She's not a sort of stereotype of a gangster's wife, you know, who normally sort of turn a blind eye and, you know, pretend that they have no idea what's going on. Like, she's very much involved and...
You're very much a partner
in
the crime and running her own enterprise.
That sounds like quite an extreme accident.
You're very sentimental about the relationship.
No. But a lot of love there, clearly, and loyalty.
Yeah. But that's true.
This couple's a couple of ballers.
Yeah.
I think the respect, that sort of mutual respect between the two characters.
Yeah.
I love that.
Tony.
What was it like to deliver some of your lines with the smallest gun known to man? Thing was an old mini water gun.
It was sort of hilarious, actually, that gun. That scene with the bullets when we first, you know, she first opens the box. I just kept cracking up laughing, you know, seeing these tiny little bullets. And that was a scene where Guy sort of was... you know, playing around with the dialogue. But yeah, it was just fun. It was, you know, I had to sort of take it really seriously and pretend it was a much bigger gun in that scene,
it
you
did,
know.
It did the work.
It does work.
Got a bit of Wagyu in the freezer as it happens.
Oh, I never had Wagyu.
Yeah, well, be wasted on you, but it's all I've got.
I'll get it, mate.
I was obsessed with that grill thing. You know, Charlie Hunnam spends most of his time with you in the backyard and they've got this grill. I actually haven't tried Wagyu, but what would you serve at your barbecue? Your backyard barbecue, what are you serving? And do you have a grill like that?
Is that a Guy Ritchie grill?
That heats up your knees and cooks at the same time. You've got to show me how to get one of them.
Possibly.
Most likely.
Yeah, I've never seen one.
You like that grill?
I loved it.
You can get one.
At Guy Ritchie's house?
He can have one probably delivered to you. For
oh, how great would that be?
I'm Wagyu ribeyes.
Oh, Wagyu, yeah. Some bangers, nice. some sausages, and some bread.
Yeah.
Simple.
Yeah.
That's what barbecue is. It's hearty, home-cooked food. It's just, you know, simple fare.
I think they're going to wrap me in a second. Nicknames, dry eyes. Everyone's got a nickname. Can you give each other a nickname? What would Henry's nickname be?
Be kind.
Handsome Henry.
Handsome Henry.
That's it. I like it.
All right.
How about Michelle? What would hers be?
Yeah, she's money.
Ooh.
Money.
Yeah, she stepped into an immense amount of dialogue about 16 hours before she needed to
understand. I heard.
And then just as she would have that dialogue down, that two-page monologue, our director, who does his best writing while you're in the scene.
Right.
Change things up.
Yeah, we're not doing that. We're doing
and the challenge is as frustrating as it would be, usually for my money, I would be like, oh, that's better.
Yeah.
Damn it.
It's true. Now yeah, normally you would fight it.
Yeah.
And like, no, I'm sticking, you know, I really want to stick to the dialogue that I've learned, you know, all night, 5 o'clock in the morning, and I only just arrived on set. But yeah, it's true. He comes up with something even better on the day.
I am not for sale.
Finally, his nickname.
Gosh. Don't look at me.
That's the bartender. What's his nickname? While you booze it up back there.
Been working on it for 18 years.
Hairline McConaughey.
Been working on it.
It looks
16
good.
Years.
It looks really
Thank
good.
You. It's all natural too, babe.
Only one rule in this jungle. When the lion's hungry, he eats.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the movie The Gentlemen. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, giveaways. I'm at an authentic British pub, and I don't have a drink in my hand. I think it's time to do just that. We'll see you at the movies.